So, bon dia, buenos dias, and good evening, everyone. I would like to extend a warm welcome to Mikhail Yakir. Dr. Yakir is, you know all, she's a botanist, ecologist, and a homeopath. And her reputation precedes her. And I'm sure you are all aware of her extensive body of work in homeopathy. I can tell you, Mikhail, it was gratifying to have your acquaintance in 2015 in Germany. I hope you remember that. So me and Dr. Vivin Sutin from Argentina had visited your seminar, you know, and absolutely we were in Magnolia state in those all the vessels and all not and all. And that was the first time we heard you. But I can tell you only and only after knowing that moment, I came to know Dr. Mahesh Gandhi is doing your way. And I can have a gratitude for him. And that's how I started learning in 2015 your theory from Dr. Gandhi, sir.
Amazing.
And really, it was mind-boggling. And as in 2018, we started, I started. Conducting the your theories seminars in Brazil and Argentina with my colleagues. So they know you from 2018. It's a long time they are waiting to see you. So
Okay.
that's how, and now in this 1 year time, actually, we are doing bi-monthly webinar. So, you know, they have grasped you enoughly, and just it was like a thanks for you to, for agreeing this to be part of this forum, and suddenly you said yes when I wrote a letter to you. And I'm really happy and I'm really privileged and honored that you are here. So we are looking forward to hear you from. Okay. And the field is yours now. You can start anytime.
Hi everyone. Oh, so many nice people, beautiful homeopaths. Okay. So when I'll talk, I'll know that I'm talking to you. Great. And you will see that as we talk, I will from time to time ask you questions and invite you to participate, your knowledge and your experience. I value your experience. Oftentimes, you do not know how much importance there is to your experience. In the last 30 years, as I worked as a homeopath and in writing and compilation information, being a research, that's a researcher, that's part of my nature. I like to collect information and analyze it. So I realize how much importance we have to cases in our materia medica. So many remedies has tiny proving, if at all, and most of it is actually cases. So many information, so much data we have of what we call remedies is actually cases. So continuing and sending cases is of utmost importance. When I started developing my book, my approach to homeopathy, then it was an idea in my head, and I started to teach it, and then people started to send me cases back. And this actually gave the biggest confirmation. So for us, sharing cases, you know, sharing small experience, even snippets of cases, is important and revealing and the only way for homeopathy to continue. So from time to time, I will ask you to intervene, and I think, I don't know if you could either just raise your hand or and then the host will I unmute you.
Okay. Mikhail, their language is a problem. So even they write something, the translator will talk to them. Something we can do it.
Okay. That's also a possibility. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So here we begin the journey of the Monocots, a group which is oftentimes ignored or overlooked. And as the Dicotyledon are more bigger and more impressive, we hear mostly about them and we overlook an important group, which we will emphasize in this seminar. Now, we will also look again at the journey of the female and male element in the table of plants as they shape the face of the table. Now, let me remind you, we are talking of only the flowering plants. I've just now, the last 2 years, I've been working of the ancient plants after years of working them only in my mind. And it's a magnificent journey, and I hope one day I will be able to talk to you about it. But we have started with the flowering plants because this is most of our materia medica and most of the known remedies. And they and the flowering plants describe the human journey, the evolution of human journey, the earth phase of human journey, which is formed and activated by the development of the I, what we called the ego. Here, the ego is not a bad word. The ego is a tool that, as any tool, can be used for good or bad. And as you could see from this picture, the flowering plants are only the seventh stage of earth evolution of land. There are six columns of ancient plants before it, from the mosses and the lycophytes and the ferns and the cicuses and the gnetophytes and lastly the conifers. The angiosperms, the flowering plants, are the last one, but they are so complicated and so diverse that we could divide them to six clear columns, which are our table.